Hello students, this is Aisha. We are studying ICT and GCSE. We are doing practical revision, unit number 13, layout. Already done one part, so today I am continuing the second part. Today we will discuss about include spreadsheet as an object, insert clip art, insert chart from different sources, create and format the table in word processing software, create headers and the footers, place automated objects in headers and footers. So let's start it one by one. First of all, how to place include a spreadsheet as an object in your word processing software. So if you want a part of the spreadsheet also, click on the insert menu, click on object. After that, you will have an option to select Microsoft Excel worksheet. If you want a new worksheet to be inserted over here. If you want already made worksheet to be inserted over here, then you can simply choose this option, create from file. Create from file, just browse that worksheet, link to file. This option will link to the file. It means if any changes or any modification is done in the Excel worksheet, it will be automatically updated over here also. Okay, so I'm going to create a new one, Microsoft Excel worksheet, click OK. Now you can see you're getting this Excel worksheet. So you can simply write, suppose I'm just writing marks, 54, 45, just a random numbers. Even you can add the formulas over here. So for detailed Microsoft worksheet, Excel or spreadsheet, we have a separate chapter. So I will discuss over there. But I'm just showing you that you can do modifications over here also. Automatically calculated. You can do the simple formatting as you do in word processing. After that, this is in editing mode now. This borders show this dash border. It is representing that this is in editing mode now. If you stop editing, then just simply double click over here on the blank area. Now editing is done. Again, if you want to do some modification, just simply double click over here. Okay, on this Excel worksheet, just simply double click. It will appear in editing mode. So this is the way you can open this, insert the Excel worksheet as an object. Second is inserting a clip art. Inserting clip art. So how to insert a clip art? Click on insert, click on clip art. Here, let me zoom this out a little bit. If you can see here, you have search bar, you can specify a keyword over here, what you want to search. Suppose I want to search for the car. Then here you have the different options, all media files, photographs, videos or audios as in clip art. Third, here you have the option include office.com. It means the clip arts that are available online at office.com will also be included. If you uncheck this, so online will not be included. So better to check this to have a more variety over here. These are the pictures from the internet as well, clip arts from the internet and from this office suite. Okay, if you want to insert any picture, simply double click on that. Secondly, if you want to see the properties of the pictures, for example, you have specified a specified size, okay, just simply click over here on this arrow and at the end you will get preview and properties. Click on the preview and properties. Look here now, you will get the resolution, type of the file, so size of the file. So if you think need all these things, so better to see the properties of this. So I'm just getting back to normal. To insert that clip art, simply double click. When you will double click on that, it will insert where your mouse cursor is placed. After that, you can do the same editing, same formatting which you have done for the pictures, for the images. We have done the separate chapter for image editing. If you have not seen that, you can go to that image editing video. So simply double click on that or click on the format tab to make it wrap text. Change the size, change the height, cropping 1.83, or you can use the crop option. So all the features which you have used for the image editing, you can do it with the clip art also. So this is how you can insert a clip art. In the word processing software. Okay, next one is, I'm just closing this one. Next is how to insert a chart. There are multiple ways. One is you can copy and paste if you have already designed the chart. You can insert chart as an object. First of all, I'm going to do it copy and paste. I have the chart in this Excel worksheet. To copy and paste, simply right click on the chart, click on copy. Okay, go to your word processing software, right click and paste. You have different options for paste, or simply you can use Control V, the short key for pasting a chart. Okay, that is for the Windows. So only the chart is over, placed with this word processing software. So you can resize that chart, even you have the different same features for the image also. Go to Format tab, you can apply the features for image editing also. So because it is placed as an image over here now. Second way is insert as an object. Let me do that. Insert object. What do you want to insert? Microsoft Excel chart. So select from here Microsoft Excel chart. Click on OK. Chart is here. Let me resize that one. If you see, that is already developed. Okay, but I have not done any modification over here. That is not my data. So here you will get these two tabs, sheet 1 and the chart 1. In the sheet 1, you can enter your data, the chart will be automatically modified. Okay, suppose I am just copying pasting this data. Okay, removing this one. So look here now, in the chart is automatically updated. And you can have the different layouts of the chart. You can add labels, axes, grids. But I'm not doing this one because for the charts also we have a separate chapter. We will do in details over there. So this is just how to insert the chart as an object, or how to insert. If you will do any modification over here, automatically the chart will be modified. So this is how you can insert it as an object. Simply click on this, you will get modification what will be turned off. If you want to modify, just double click on that. This is how you can insert a chart, clip art and spreadsheet. Next part is create a table with a specified number of rows and columns. If you want to insert a table in your word processing software, how you can insert that one? I'm just inserting that over here. Click on insert table. From here you can specify the number of rows and columns also, for example 5x4, or simply you can click on insert table and number of columns and number of rows you can specify. Let's suppose I want 7 columns and 3 rows. Okay, you can specify number of columns and rows. Click OK. With the 7 columns and 3 rows, chart is inserted. Now you can do formatting with the chart also. You can insert text over here. Text formatting is same. Simply click on the Home tab, highlighting. I'm just removing the highlighting. You can change the color. Text formatting is same as we do in the normal word processing software. You can insert as an object, insert any object in this cell also. How you can insert? Same way, click on insert object. Okay, let's suppose I want to insert a bitmap image over here. Click OK. Just a simple bitmap to show you how to insert that. That's it. Update document. So automatically it will be inserted. But now look at this height, row height. It is automatically increased according to that. So what you have to do, you have to change the size, format and all these things for this. Okay, let's suppose this is 1.97, I'm doing it 0.97. Let me text type that one, square. Now you can resize from here also, and you can resize from here also. Okay. So these are the multiple ways. So you have to adjust your object according to the cell height, according to the cell width. If you want to insert a, let me do it in the next page. If you want to insert a big picture, so what you have to do, what you can do, you can merge two or more cells. Okay, you can merge two or more cells. How you can do that? Simply select that cells sorry. For example, I want to do heading over here. I want to merge these three cells. So what you can do, go to layout, click on merge cells. Merge cells mean combining two or more cells to make it a single cell. Okay, combining two or more cells to make it a single cell. So for the heading mostly we use this one. Okay, so for headings or for large data we can merge the cells. Okay, similarly you can split the cells, split mean divide the cells. For example, here I want two cells over here instead of one, two cells, but not for the rest of the table. So what I will do, click on this layout tab and then split cells. After that, what do you want? I want two columns over here and one row on this specific cell. So click OK. Look here now. This is divided into two cells now. So in the same way, you can split the cells and merge the cells. Rest you can do formatting over here or for the table. Simply right click over here, click on table properties. Okay, table properties. When you will click on table properties, you will get this properties for the table. You can set the row height. For example, exactly I said exactly all the row height should be 0.5 inch. Okay, here you have option at least or exactly 0.5 inch. I want that one. Click OK. Look here now, all the rows are exactly 0.5 inch now. So again go to table properties. Similarly, you can specify the column width just by selecting measures in inches. You can specify the cell width. You can specify the cell alignment also. Top, center, bottom. Let's suppose I want all this in the center. So I will click on the center option. Click OK. So text will be at the center of the cell. Okay, it will be in the center of the cell. Again, you can have the design over here. Different designs option are available. You can go to borders. Click on border and shading. Okay, from here you can go from the design tab, borders, border and shading. You can select the designs of the border. Suppose I want this design. I want this color. Okay, width can be specified. This width. Here you can specify. Do you want only the outside boundary or inside cells also? Click over here. This is unchecked now. Okay, it means column will be unchecked. Click over here. This is unchecked now. So I want all this. So I'm just simply clicking over here. Or you can select from here also. I suppose I don't want the right border. I don't want the left border. Only this I want. Or I don't want the upper and the lower border also. Only inside border I want. Okay, apply to whole table or the text or the paragraph. I'm applying to whole table. You can do page border from here also, but I'm just concerned about the table border right now, so I'm doing it from here. Even you can apply the shading, means background color, to your table. I want this background color for my table. Apply to the table, click OK. Look here now, outside borders are not there because I have unchecked that one. So according to your requirements, you can apply the borders and the shadings and then do alignments from here also. So this is how you can insert the table, format the table, format its contents. Contents are same as we have done for the text and objects also. Wrap text around the table. We have done for the images that you can wrap the images. So you can also wrap the text around the images also. Okay, for the wrap text, suppose I'm just reducing the size now. Just right click over here, table properties. From here you can do the text wrapping. You want none or the round. Okay, even you can specify the positioning. Left, column, right, center, inside, outside. So you can specify the positioning of the wrap text as we have done in the image editing. Okay, and click OK. Look here now, text is wrapped with the table. So this is how you can do wrap text. So I'm doing it again down. So just resizing that one again to the normal. Next is inserting a row or column in an existing table. You have these three rows, but you want to insert more rows over here. There are multiple ways. One is just right click over here, insert row above that row or below that row. I want below that row. So one more row is inserted over here. Okay. Similarly, you can insert the column. Just right click, insert column. Where you want to insert a new column, at the left side or at the right side? Maybe at the left side. So one more column is inserted over here. Okay, and if you want to delete a column, select the column or the multiple columns, just select that one, right click, delete columns. Okay, columns are deleted. Similarly, if you want to delete a row, just right click on the row, and from the delete cell you can also do entire row, entire column. For the cell, let me show you. Suppose I have written 1 over here, 2 over here, 3 over here. I want to remove this cell, delete this cell. So what will happen? There are multiple options. Right click, delete cells. These are the four options. Shift cell left, shift cell up, delete entire row, entire column. If I do shift cell left, so the contents of cell 2 will be moved over here. Let me do that. Click OK. Look here now. One is removed, but the content of cell 2 is moved to the left side. Undo. And if I do the second option, delete cells, shift cells up. So what will come here now? The contents of this cell, the below cell, will be moved towards that cell. Shift cell up, click OK. Look here now. 3 is moved in place of 1. So this is how you can delete the cell. If you do not want to delete the cell, only you want to delete the contents. Contents mean whatever it's written over here. Simply press the delete button. So contents will be deleted. Cell will remain as it is. Contents will be deleted. Okay. This is how you can insert a row or column, delete a row or column. If you want to resize a specific column or specific row, what you have to do, for example, I have here serial number. Here I want name. So the name, its length should be more than serial number. Just what you have to do, move your mouse pointer at the row. When this turns like this double arrow, click and drag according to your specified position. For the name, I want increase, move your mouse pointer at the edge and click and drag. Only that row, only that column is increased. Similarly, for the row height, move your mouse pointer over here, increase the row height. Okay, or you can decrease the row height also. Second way is you can change from the layout tab. Specify the height and the width. Okay, let's suppose for this row, for third row, height is 0.47, I want 1 inch. Only for the third row, height is now 1 inch. So there are multiple ways. From the layout tab, you can also do from here drag and drop method. If you want specific height and width, then better to go for the layout option. If you want randomly, then you can go with this option, drag and drop option. So this is how you can format the table and the contents of our table, resizing, inserting, and deleting. The last topic for this layout is creating headers and footers. Okay, why we need headers and footers? It's basically show the information that may not be directly related to your content, but that is still important. Just like about the author, about the page numbers. So these type of things we use in headers and footers instead of writing directly on the main content. So how to insert headers and footers? Click on the insert menu. Insert menu. Click on footer header. So let's suppose I want a footer over here. Click on the footer. Some automatic suggestions will be there if you want to choose this one. Otherwise, you can simply click on edit header. Edit header. This is your footer area because I clicked on the footer option. So this is your footer area. So what you can insert over here, you can insert over automated page number. Okay, or you can write yourself if you want to write anything over here. I suppose I want to write learning layout. Okay. If you want to insert a date and time, you can insert date and time from here. Format, check, select the format. Suppose I want this one, click OK. Now here, look here now, these are combined with each other. But what I want this date should be appeared in the center of the footer. So what I will do, simply click here, insert alignment tab. From here, let's set the position. I want to it at the center or I want it at the right. Click on the right, click OK. Now this part is at the right side and this part is at the left side. So this is how you can insert. Similarly, you can do it for the headers also. If you want to remove, you can simply click on the remove header or footer. I'm going to do header now. Okay, header is at the top side. At the top side, what you can insert over here? Suppose I want quick parts over here. Quick parts we have already done. Auto text, field, document property. I want author name over here. Write the author name. I'm just writing my name over here. Okay, I also want the file name over here at the header. Okay, so again I can go to quick part, building blocks. From here you can select, sorry. Field. So from here you can select file properties, file name, file size. I want file name to be a pair. If I add path to the file name, it will include all the path. Click over here and click OK. So look here, with all the path, file name is mentioned over here. Again, if you want to set its alignment, go to insert alignment tab. I want it at the right side. Okay, click OK. So this is at the right side. So in this way, you can insert the quick parts also, insert the page numbers, automatic page numbers from here. At the current position, I want to insert the page number. There are different formats for the page number. I'm inserting this one, page X of Y. So wherever my cursor is, it will show you page 6 of 6. If you want to come back to the normal document, just simply double click over here at your document. Okay, dot at the footer area, but simply at the document. So this is how you can insert headers and footers. You can include automated file information, automated page number. If you will increase or decrease the pages, it will automatically change. No need to change it. Text, date and time. From this insert option, you can do all these things. And you can do alignment over here. So this is all for the layout. Thank you very much for listening. If you have any question related to the practical part, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you.